Blessings, blessings to you guys. Blessings. We have something that we want to share with you guys.
Yes, Paula White. And I believe that a lot of people don't talk about Paula White. I don't know why, but we need to. We need to bring up the things that she is doing. And, you know, she's done some things throughout the years that has been very questionable. Allegedly, you know, she was holding hands with Benny Hinn in another country. Now, I've seen that on pictures. And, you know, it's been a lot of things going on with her being in different relationships with different men outside of marriage, allegedly. But now we want to talk about this situation because you hear this coming from out of her own mouth. Yep. Christianity has gotten so out of control with this money scheme. But let's listen to it.
So sad.
For though. Yourself. Mm.
Speaking prophetically by the Holy Spirit, and you are to sow a $3,000 seed. When you are.
You have to sow a $3,000 seed. These people have mind, man. No conscience.
Know it.
Obey the voice of the Lord. And you do what God's telling you to do.
You need to send in $35,000. You need to send in that $100,000 check. I'm telling you, and God has mandated, if you do not write that P.O. box and you do not call that toll-free number and you do not become a ministry of sustainer, you will never see sustainment in your...
Speaking prophetically by the Holy Spirit, and you are to sow a $3,000 seed. When you obey the voice of the Lord, and you do what God's telling you to do.
You need to send in $35,000. You need to send in that $100,000 check. I'm telling you, and God has mandated, if you do not write that P.O. box and you do not call that toll-free number and you do not become a ministry of sustainer, you will never see sustainment in your life and your dream will die.
Your dream will die.
I know. What's up with these false preachers saying if you don't do this, you don't do that, your dream will die and all
fear.
This other stuff.
Fear.
And I'm over here like, are you had a lot of them are so desperate for money that this is what they do. They just want this money because they got some bill to pay or some activity to do because this is really, really harsh.
And this happens. Hey, when we bring video like this, all you need to do is do your own research. Go back this week, last month, they're still doing the same thing.
Yeah.
And a lot of gullible members are still falling for this. They will watch this video and you will cry out loud, hey, this is a scam. This is fraud. The gullible members don't care. They think, oh, you jealous of their pastor? Jealous of who? Or you are attacking the man of God? Who is the man of God here? What type of heart do these people have? Why will you be standing and saying something boldly like this? Our God is not a mean God. Our God is not a God that sit back and wait for people to give to him first before he respond to them. What is this?
You know, I feel for the people who was watching her programs during this time and they feeling convicted in their spirit to give when it's all a lie and their rent could have been due. You know, they probably didn't have no food in the house. But since they watched the program, they felt like, oh, my God, I'm getting, you know, I'm not being obedient.
Yeah.
I need to send money. And then you over here losing your house and losing the food that you supposed to feed for your children. You know, the intimidation is wrong. And they don't get in trouble with it either. They don't get in trouble with it. They do whatever they want to do. They, you know, all this stuff they own, the tax, they don't have to pay taxes. That's what I'm saying. They don't have to pay taxes on any of this stuff. They're getting away with a lot, you know.
People of God, y'all need to know this. Not every video that you click on is brought to you by God.
Come on.
Not every video that you click on has been directed from heaven. God will still want you to jump on somebody's live video. It's not just for you to, oh, maybe God brought me here to sow a seed. No. God still wants you to see the stupidness in some of these preachers. God wants you to see something so you can correct yourself. God wants you to, hey, look at this shenanigans. Look at this madness. Not ever. I don't know why people think, oh, I watched Benny Hinn. Immediately I jumped in on Benny Hinn, called out money. Was it the only time that you hear that? Why can't you jump in and hear for repentance and you repent? People, please understand this whole thing. I see some people, oh, wow, now I see the reason why I clicked on this video. No, God wants you to have discernment. Test the fruit. Is this truly from God, or do you feel convicted with fear? Is your conscience bearing you witness that this is of God? Even your conscience might be bearing witness, it might still be enemy speaking in your mind. Mm-hmm. Because they will tell you, obey. Mm-hmm. Whether you like it or not, there's something speaking in our mind all the time. So you have to be very careful with all this, using it as a sign of God, as a, this is the will of God. Stop. Mm-hmm. Stop falling for these scammers.
That Jezebel spirit needs to leave.
Yeah.
Because that's exactly what is hovering over a lot of people, men and women, in the body of Christ. And that's sad. Mm. We don't need Jezebel to control our churches, ministries.
We don't.
You know? So I pray that Paula White will give her life to Christ Jesus.
So I hope so.
I believe that this woman I believe that this woman does not have Jesus in her. I believe that she just want to do what she want to do. She's faking it until she make it.
Yeah.
But people need to fall back in love with God again. Yeah. Fall in love with Jesus, Paula White. And you know what you're doing wrong. You know exactly what you're doing wrong. And a lot of people who are around you know that you're doing wrong. But it will come a time where God ain't going to play with a lot of y'all anymore.
No.
He's a patient God. He's so patient that I even wonder how he can do it. But yeah, we wanted to bring this forth because, you know, if you feel like you've been going through the situation when you're listening to these ministers, you know,
don't rebuke yourself.
Yeah, don't.
Just rebuke yourself right away.
Don't do it. Don't do it. You know, y'all, if everybody keep allowing them to do this, the more they will do it. But, you know, that's what's going on. Their congregation is growing every day. Their numbers are growing every day. And they feel like they're getting away with it. They're really getting rich off of this. Go get a job, okay?
It's better for these people when you rebuke them in person in their church. It's better they call you an antichrist.
Yeah.
It's better they call you that and let God call you my son.
Amen.
So much better.
Amen.
Because they call Jesus some names. So let them call you those names, but let God honor what you are doing.
Mm. Amen.
We love you guys.
Thank you for watching.
Bye, y'all.
Bye.